The Delta variant is a little bit unusual because it's so highly contagious. It spreads so rapidly. And it seems to be causing significant illness in people who are unvaccinated, including people who are younger. We have other variants that are circulating, such as the Gamma variant. We expect additional variants to pop up. This is not unexpected. And in fact, use of masks and use of vaccination is what's going to really decrease the number of variants that are going to spread in the future going forward. All of the vaccines are very, very, very effective at their endpoint, which is preventing hospitalizations and death in patients. We still see things like breakthrough infections in people who've been vaccinated. So you've gotten the vaccine, you get a mild illness, and you recover. And that is absolutely expected. That doesn't mean that the vaccines aren't doing what they're supposed to do, which is decrease hospitalizations and death. The FDA has approved a booster shot for the Pfizer vaccine for a very, very specific group of people. These are people whose immune systems don't work quite as well as other people's. These would be people with organ transplant, people with AIDS, people who are on certain medications that really, really suppress their immune system. There's a list available on the CDC website, and this is constantly being updated. Right now, the FDA is also looking at data about offering a third shot for people who got vaccinated more than 8 months ago because of the possibility that their immunity might be decreasing just a little bit. This would just be to boost up the immune system so people do not get COVID this fall and they stay healthy. The masks add an extra layer of protection on top of us when we've been vaccinated. And so currently we are recommending that indoors people wear masks. Outdoors, there's much less risk of transmission. And so when you're outdoors and you're more than 6 feet away from other people, you don't need a mask. The University of Toledo has recently put in place vaccine requirements. Currently, we are requesting that all members of our university community receive the COVID vaccine and that they upload proof of vaccination onto the website. This is extremely important to keep our university community safe and healthy this fall.